Hello students, this is Abhijit Shah from SNCS. Today I will discuss about one geography topic, population dynamics. Okay, so at first you see, what is population? The word population signifies the total number of people inhabiting a specific area at a particular time. So population means that now how many people are there. So number of people inhabiting in a specific area. Okay. Population is not static, it is ever changing. That means it is not fixed. Okay, day by day it is changing and dynamic in nature. And population dynamics deals with the study of how and why population change in size and structure over time. So population dynamics means that this topic is deals with the study that in what way the population are changes and the in what way the population structure is situated. Okay, so you can see the world's population, that the highest population number of population is situated in China. 18.9% population are under China, and the second one is India. 17.9% people are under India. This is the percentage, and next one is USA, next is Indonesia, this way. Okay, distribution of population in the world. So the statistics show the distribution of global population as of mid 2018 by continent. In 2018, about 59.5% of global population was living in Asia. So global population data shows us one information, that 59.5% peoples are belongs from Asia. Okay, the world's population is continuous rising and has nearly tripled since 1950. So Asia's percentage is 59.5%. Next one is 16.8 carried by Africa. Okay, next, in 2050 the total world population was 7.35 billion people, and mainly due to the rapid growth of developing countries, the human population will continue to grow in the coming decades and is expected to exceed approximately 11.2 billion by 2100, according to a global population forecast by the United Nations. So United Nations gave a data about the population, that they estimate that within 2100 or 2100 years, that the population will cross 11.2 billion. Okay, now it's 7.35 billion. Global population, due to medical advances, better living conditions, and the increase of agricultural productivity, the world population is expected to grow. So why the population is increasing? Because the medical advances, better living condition is there, and the agriculture productivity is also high. That's what the population is increasing, for the better infrastructure, better condition of the people. And Asia is the most populous continent on earth, and China is the country with the largest population. So in the China, the population is the largest. Next is factors affecting the size of population. What are the factors? Okay, so as discussed earlier, the population of the planet is constantly increasing, and this growth can have many effects on the environment and the economy of the world. So the population of a country, this is also one kind of indicator or factors of the environmental condition and the economic condition. For example, as the world population rises, the pressure mounts on the agriculture sector to feed the millions of increased people. There are several factors that affect the size of population in the world, that fertility rate, on birth rate, death rate or mortality rate, immigration and emigration. So these are the factors. They actually regulate the number of population, that how much fertility rate is there, or the birth rate, it is also called as death rate, or it is also called as mortality rate, and the another is immigration or emigration. So first come to the fertility rate or birth rate. The factors that affect the growth of population in the biggest way in the fertility or birth rate. Okay, the fertility rate is typically measured by the number of children per one woman of bearing age. So fertility means that how many childs are born in a year as the ratio of women. If the fertility rate is larger than 2, Okay, the population should rise as there were more children than their parents. Okay, so if every woman carried two child, then the population will increase rapidly. And on the other hand, if this ratio is below 2, the population of the region may be destined for a decline. And generally, birth rate refers to the number of live births per 1000 persons in given geographical area per year. Next is mortality or death rate, a key factor affecting the growth of population in the death or mortality rate. Just as the birth of new people increasing the population size, a death decreases it. So mortality or death rate means that according to the woman number of women, how many childs are died. The factors that affect the mortality rate include the availability of quality of healthcare and lifestyle habit. For example, that whether they smoke or do physical exercise regularly, or death rate refers to the number of death per 1000 people in given geographical area per year. So it is not only related with child, that in a year how many people are died in a year according to or with respect to 1000 people, it is called as mortality rate. Okay. Next is immigration and emigration. Cross-border migration is the act of people moving from one country to another, and it affects the population size of both the host and the destination countries. Emigration means to move out of a particular place. Emigration means when people shifted their place from their own place to another place. This is called as immigration or emigration. That means they are called as migration. And this migration is we can divide into two parts: when people shifted into the another new area from their own country, then it is called as emigration. And immigration means if they come back into their own country, then it is called as immigration. Okay, so immigration is caused by the number of factors such as where education. So why people said emigrate into new country? Because for the where like situation, educational facility, seeking new jobs, joining one family. For this reason, some people they emigrate from their own country to another country. When a person emigrates from a country, its population shrinks. And when someone moves to a country from another place, it is known as immigration. And when they come back into their own nation, then it is called as immigration. And whether or not a person is allowed to immigrate is controlled by the country that will host this person.